The interaction between the mesh and nutritional state is very complex and not yet well known. The aim of the present study was to assess the interaction between cognitive impairment and nutritional state in a cohort of residential elderly, in relationship with functional condition of patients and their assistants with load. The study was conducted in long-term care of the National Association of Fair Age Structures, ANAS de Calabria. ANASTE is an Italian association category of nursing homes to care for frail elderly. It's a member of ECHO, European Confederation of Care Organizations, that's pursuing social and scientific objectives in long-term care services for the elderly in Europe. The scientific committee ANASTE Calabria was founded in 2007, and its aims are promoting studies and research in the clinical and social field of the residential facilities for the elderly. In the study, we evaluated 122 female and 52 male admitted in LTC ANASTE Calabria. All patients underwent multidimensional geriatric assessment, especially mean nutritional assessment was used for nutritional state, mini metastase examination for cognitive performance, Bartel index and activity daily living score for functional state. Albumin, cholesterol, iron and hemoglobin were evaluated too. All patients were reassessed 108 days later. A severe cognitive impairment, mini metastase examination performance was displayed in 50% of patients, while 40% showed a moderate deficit and 70% had slight deficit. In mini nutritional assessment, 30% exhibited an impairment of nutritional state, 56% was at risk of malnutrition, and 14% had no nutritional problems. Malnutrition was present in 42% of patients with severe cognitive impairment, but only 4% of malnourished patients showed moderate cognitive deficit. The statistical analysis displayed a significant correlation between mini nutritional assessment and mini metastase examination, which is also correlated with ADL and Bartel index score. Instead, mini nutritional assessment is correlated with Bartel index score and albumin. The follow-up showed a strong correlation between the deterioration and worsening of nutritional state, the functional state, and mortality. The results of the present study show that it's necessary to set appropriate nutritional interventions in patients with mild, moderate dementia. In fact, these patients have more opportunities of therapeutic response than those suffering from severe dementia. In LTC ANASTE Calabria, the multidisciplinary team is trained to carry out the assessment of nutritional state. In conclusion, malnutrition plays an important role in the progression of cognitive decline. Early recognition and treatment of malnutrition are important to increase the quality of care and the quality of life of patients with dementia.